Ah. All right, I told myself I wasn't gonna say it, but I'm up in this biff. I had to, I'm sorry, it's horrible, but first of all, let's get everyone up out of your seat. That's first thing first. First thing first, we're standing up. And those who don't wanna stand, sit down and do it, it's fine. We're still moving though, either way, show must go on. All right, so. Again, my name is Quentin Robinson. I've been dancing for 20 years and counting. I'll get into everything else afterwards, but as of right now, I need you to mirror me as I move, okay? I'm gonna teach you a few counts, all right? So I'm gonna drop you into my realm a little bit of what I love to do. So first thing first, right hand goes up, all right? Which means you're left, because you're mirroring me. Ah, you should have said it. Yeah, you're mirroring me, sorry about that. I still confuse myself and everyone else around me, which is fine, we're learning. So, on the count of three, I'm gonna say 5, 6, 7, 8, and we're gonna go 1. And when we go 1, you're gonna lean to your left just a little bit, just a tiny bit, all right? So we're gonna say 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. And then when I say and 2, we're gonna go and 2, right? And then we're gonna go and 3, 4. Now, this is the tricky part, all right? This is the tricky part, need some focus. We're gonna go, what, right? Now, we're gonna slide it once like this and close it. Now, I'm gonna go the easy route since, you know, time is a thing here. We're gonna go up, and then we're just gonna close it down. All right, so let's try that again, slow. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Slide it close, slide it up, close it down. All right, now, let's see how that feels with a little bit of influence, all right? So can we get some music going for us real quick? All right. Right, feel that? A little bit of movement, right? So, I'm gonna count it off, and then we jump into it, okay? Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, oh, what? Whoa, whoa! Thank you. We can take a seat now. It's just that one little thing that everyone was like, you lied. That's all right. All righty. Oh, whew. So basically, dance is every part of my life. Dance is everything that I do, moving from point A to point B while I'm walking. You may see me like start doing this. Just weird stuff while I'm standing still. I may like shake a little bit and like move and like, oh, what's going on? It's the mannequin challenge. But here we go. I draw all of my inspiration from one person, and I still, like, I strive to be half or 25% of what she was, all right? And it takes a lifetime to get there, and that person happens to be Florette Forrest. And that is my mother. Yes, she's the meanest, feistiest, angriest, nicest, most beautiful, hostile, peaceful person you'll ever meet in your entire life. All right? I'm one of five. I'm the youngest. I'm the smallest. All of my brothers are the massive, big dudes, terrifying, but I love them. And my sister, she's the oldest. And growing up, we didn't have much of anything. We didn't have, well, we had what we needed. We didn't always get what we wanted. Which, when we grew up together, we learned to bond. We learned to work with each other. We learned to fight through struggles. Growing up, there's a fight every single day coming over the overpass in Lauderhill Middle School, Fort Lauderdale, Florida. I grew up in Lauderhill, and a lot of times I'll travel to Miami and there's just fights all day. You learn to fight before you learn to do anything else because that's what you have to do. For no reason. Just walking down the wrong street, you're gonna fight. So, I had to get away from that. But this is around the age where I started to like realize dance was a thing. I was like, oh, I like dance. Dance is something that it could take me away. It can take me away from the problems. It can take me away from the issues. I can be whatever I want to be. I could just not get shot by being outside, walking home from school, or just hanging out after school at the wrong time in the wrong place. So we spent most of our time in the basement collabing and dancing, and you know, you'll hear dance a lot throughout my entire journey. These guys right here, from right to left, Tony Turbo, Liquid, myself, John Boogs in the back, Jig Style, Iota, and Ninja Nail. Weird names, it's all good. My dance name is SpecialFX, by the way. These are the guys that I grew up dancing with. I grew up dancing with these guys, sixth grade. Skipped school, my mom threw chains on the dresser. She was like, you woke up late, ride the bus. I'm like, all right, got it. Went out to the bus stop, didn't have enough change. Well, she's gone, going back in the house. Went back in the house, popped in the tape. Tape's called Breaking. Who's familiar with the movie Breaking? Nice. All right, so pop in the movie Breaking, grab a broom, and I start doing start doing that entire dance. Third time watching it, my brother Andre walks in. One of my older brother walks in. He's like, what are you doing home? I was like, oh, I'm glad. Wait, what are you doing home? It's 10 o'clock. You know, I was like, it's 10 o'clock. What are you doing home, dude? So he asked me what I was doing. I was like, he's like, you sweeping the carpet? I was like, no. I'm watching this film and I'm doing a dance. So turns on the thing, I turn on the VHS again. Beautiful contraption. And I rewind it. After I rewind it, I do the dance for my brother. And he's like, no, you're doing it wrong. He's going left and you're going right. It's like, oh, it's that mirror thing that I still get confused with, right? So immediately in my head, I snapped and I was like, okay, I'll do it the other way around. So I did it the other way around without practicing it. I just reversed it. From there, my brother pushed me into a crowd after school with these guys because he was like, hey, my brother can do that. And he pushed me in the crowd. I was like, no. And started dancing. And these are the guys that I've been dancing with since the sixth grade. They all do positive work around the world. Amazing troop of people. So with that, play football, do all of these things, sports, and boom, I go to the military. Scholarships to play football, scholarships to run track. Nope, I go to the military. Went to the Marine Corps, 5 days. Walked in on Monday, enlisted, flew out on Friday. Didn't know anything about the Marine Corps. My dad was in the Army. Of course, that pissed him off a little bit, but it was okay. Went to the Marine Corps, graduated, joined MARSOC, did a couple of things out there, ran around, some jumping, some tours, Afghan, all that good stuff. And then, always went back to dance. No matter what happened on base, no matter what happened around me, always reverted back to movement. That's that alter ego. How could one dance and be in the military at the same time? Like, that's a strange thing just to have going on in your life and to love both just the same. All right? Then I had trolls. Two of them. Maya and QJ Robinson. QJ is short for, Quentin Jr. Maya, my little girl. 9 and 6 now. Whew. That's my little man. I often get to show him things that I do. I often get to share things with him, show him how to, what not to, and go for it, go. I'll pick you up when you fall down. It's okay, go for it. Because that's a part of what life should be about. Trial, error. If you're gonna fail with flying colors, mean it, and own it, learn from it, grow from it, find another route. You know, a lot of the times I often get calls from my family like, hey, you doing all right up there? Because I'm in Missoula, Montana. Population, -3 African American men. You know, it is that way. But I love it. It's a beautiful location. And you run into your hiccups every now and again, but that's anywhere you go around the globe. You learn to deal, you learn to adapt and overcome. My brother called me up, you all right? You need us to come in? I'm like, no. I'm practicing my rope-a-dope right now. It's all good. We're getting it going. We'll be all right. I started dancing when I moved back to Missoula, Montana. That was the first time I started like, okay, I'm going to perform, I'm going to teach. And I ran into these hooligans right here. Dimitri in the front, Ruby, Ainsley, Ellie, and Boone. Two of those goons belong to Elkie Galveston right here. She's amazing and everything. I can't get into that because that'll take out the rest of my time. But they got me back passionate with movement. They got me back into that role of, okay, this is something that moves. It's no longer dance, it's movement. Everyone dances. Anyone can dance. We all just dance just now. But can you move? And when I say can you move a crowd? Can you move a thought process? Can you move a system? That's what I use dance as. That's why it's so important to me, taking it to different perspectives. Then I go to Hatch. One of these lovely gentlemen, James, he'll be up, I think, today, as a matter of fact. I go to Hatch. Hatch changed my entire thought process. It changed, I just want to teach dance to, hey, I want to teach dance internationally. Oh, no, I want to teach dance and connect these students from Africa with the students here at the University of Montana, but I want to do it live. Oh, no, I don't want to just do that. I want to go over to Camp Make a Dream and teach kids who go through traumatic injury, mental and physical, how to reconnect their mind with their body, how to get them back into one. Because we're so disconnected from our body daily. We go to work, we just float to work, we sit down, or we stand, or we do a motion all day long because it's the thing that we're programmed to do. But that person who's gone through this traumatic injury or rehabilitation, they take every step. They're learning how to walk again. They're taking every step. They're not taking every step for granted. So they're learning, they're relearning everything. And that's something that with movement, you learn every single portion, every single movement that can enhance or bring value to travel, to a system, to an environment, to a thought, to someone who's in pain, to someone who's hurting. This was the most terrifying thing on the planet for me growing up, or as an adult black male dancer out there in another location like Montana. You may not realize it or you may not understand it, but this right here, most African-American men would be like, oh no, high five, little girl. I'm like, all right, and back up, you know? But with dance, there's a different embrace. There's a different viewpoint. Dance is literally a universal language. It changes. It's evolutionary. It changes the moment music comes on. Dance is something, it's fluent in every language of expression. We can go anywhere around the world and move, no matter where you go, no matter what the situation, you can go around the world and you can move with people that speak not one lick of English or whatever language it is you speak. And then from there, I just went on a teaching spree, from ballet, modern, jazz, African, just flying across the globe and flying over to Africa and went to a bunch of events with Hatch and just performed with multiple people. Victor Wooten, Blind Pilot, Butterscotch, Philip Shepherd. He tore the stage up last year, I believe. And just lots and lots of personnel I had the opportunity to work with and bring movement to the craft. Hatch Chicago, that's when I figured I'll take my craft and I'll expand it. I'll expand it to use it as a vehicle, not only to get into the door, but to get into the minds and get into the perspective of others. And with that perspective, it comes a responsibility, because you're going to be viewed from different directions, different lights, different everything. It's just going to be completely different no matter what. Once you step into that spotlight, once you step into the stage, you're at the mercy of everyone around you, especially performing. These are a few clips from Africa where, again, we didn't speak the language, but we did speak the same language and movement. That's Poppin' Joseph. Thought to be beheaded, thrown in a pile of his family members, found by a Somalian. When I asked him in an interview, why did you survive and everyone else didn't? His answer was to spread love and dance. That was Poppin' Joseph's answer. One of the strongest people I've ever met. And this is just some workshops we did over there, had a great time. And I wanted to share with you a small clip of just that. So here we go.
So I hope you all are ready to have some fun. We're getting ready to start this up and join in.
You never feel happy. Never feel happy. No, you won't. Until you try, you never feel happy.
This isn't the last time we're going to connect. Those dancers are forever going to be a part of what I do. There's not many words to describe that feeling. It's simply amazing. After going through what they've gone through, after witnessing what they've witnessed in their lifetime, after being in a refugee settlement, they're out in the field, dancing with me.
And I'm feeling good.
Hey, river running free. You know how I feel. Blossom on the tree. You know how I feel. It's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
And I'm going to do it because I never give up. Never give up.
Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean? Sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean.
Stronger, more than power, power never ever after work is over. Work it, make it, do it, makes us harder, better, faster, stronger. Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger. More than ever, hour after hour, work is never over. Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger. More than ever, hour after hour, work is never over. Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger. More than ever, hour after hour, work is never over. Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger. More than ever, hour after hour, work is never over. Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger. More than ever, hour after hour, work is never over. Work it never over. Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger. More than ever, hour after hour, work it never over.
Thank you, Saul.
And lastly, I just wanted to show you where I get my inspiration from and why. My mom passed away June of last year, but she still moves. She still moves, she still dances, she still moves me. So.